Hello guys, welcome to my channel today, and today I'm going to show you my purple Digimon deck profile. Before we start, I just wanted to show you my amazing sleeves. It is Jibril from the No Game No Life, and I got them in Japan again. You just should go to Japan and buy lots of sleeves, and it will just basically give you back money for that ticket that you paid to go to Japan. So now let's go to our main deck profile. Today I'm using 5 Digitamas. So Pagumon is very good Digitama. In case you don't like Yakumon at all, you can just play 4 Digitamas and do not play the 5th one. And moving to the main profile, we are playing 4 copies of Demidevimon. It is very good rookie, it only costs 2 to play, which helps you a lot. Then we play 4 copies of Impmon. Impmon as well, very important card in this deck, as you have to have that trash zone to play this deck. Then we have 3 copies of Tapiramon. So Tapiramon, we play only 3 copies of it, as it is good card, but 3 copies is just enough. You will always see it in your game, so no worries. Then we have 4 copies of Gabumon. Gabumon is very good card. It gives you draw 2 and discard 1, which you need a lot in this deck to fill your trash zone as fast as you can. Then we have level 4s, 3 copies of Wizardmon. Wizardmon works with the yellow Digimon, so in the future you might see it a lot being used with the yellow Digimons, as well as it is very good with the Gabumon. In case your Digimon will be deleted like that, you will draw 3 cards and then discard 1. Then we have 4 copies of blockers. In this game it is very important to have blockers in your deck, and as well as we are using Piedmon or Piedmon, you will need to have those in your trash zone, so you just can revive them back using Piedmon's skill. Then we play 4 copies of Devimon, super good card. It gives you a lot of control over the opponent's field, as you can anytime just kill your opponent's Digimon and make a suicide together with this Digimon. And it works very nice if you have him and blocker on the field. Your opponent will have a lot of pain in that. Then we play 2 copies of Miotismon. So it is just very easy to place 5 level Digimon, so you can digi evolve your level 6 next turn on him. Then we use 4 copies of Chimeramon. Chimeramon is super good Digimon. You place it, you destroy your opponent's level 5, and level 5s in this game is super important for your opponent. That is why this card is so good. And then we play 2 copies of Piedmon. So Piedmon just gives you instantly full field when you play it. That's why I like him a lot. Then we play 2 copies of Belzemon. I like him a lot as well, as again it has instantly skill when digievolved, destroy one of your opponent's level 4 or lower Digimon. And it is just super fast, as you can evolve with him on the Impmon. Right? Meaning that you will get that level 6 on your field instantly. And that is super impressed. impressing, whatever. Okay. Then we have one Metal Garurumon. So Metal Garurumon, it is actually very nice card. I suggest trying it as well. And if you don't have Belzmon or something, you can even play two copies of it, as it only costs 3 memory to digi-evolve it on your Chimeramon that you will basically have on the field all the time. And when he attacks, every turn you will get to revive one of your rookies. And that is so good. Also, you will always have your purple tamer on your, on the side of the field, so you will always have that 3 memory to just attack with the rookie, dies, digi-evolve, revive. So that is just super good. Then we have one Magnadramon. So Magnadramon gives us plus 2 security recovery, which is a lot. But in case you're having troubles with the rookie rush in your locals, you can always swap it with the Volcanic Dramon. Then we have 2 Millenniemon. So Millenniemon, it gives you a lot of option against Omnimon players. So that is why we are using it in this deck. And if you noticed, we did not use Lilithmon in this deck. So we are not using Lilithmon together with the Millenniemon in one deck, because it just breaks a lot. And Lilithmon, you actually need a little bit more setup for Lilithmon to be fully effective. That is why I decided not to play here, as I like level 6s that gives me benefits instantly. But Lilithmon is super good card as well, and in the future we will get a lot of new option cards. That's why Lilithmon will become just always step by step stronger, as you don't even need to use purple options to get that effect. So yeah. Then we using one Heat Viper. So Heat Viper is very good card against opponents that like to play a lot of level 4. Then we play only 3 copies of Tramsword. I don't like 4 copies of it, because again, it breaks a little bit in your hand. The 3 copies of it, it's just right number for me. Then we play 3 copies of Nitrate. I was thinking of adding the 4th one, but instead I added Demi-Devimon, because if you start playing Digimon, you will need to have a rookie in your opening hand. That's why it is just better to have any rookie in your opening hand that costs 2 to play or something, to just be able to digi-evolve and draw one card. And Nitrate, it requires to have you some trash cards in your trash zone to actually use it. And finally, we are using 3 copies of Matt Ishida. So 4 copies, 3 copies, it doesn't really matter, but for me 3 copies is a good number. It is a good card, and I probably like it the most from the all option cards right now that we have in the game. So that is all in today's video. Please subscribe and see you in the next video. Mama and I.